when the last chorus has grown silent. Well, there's always sugar for the horses. Always sugar for the horses.
Hey, Wayne Williams, speaking of horses, the Equus Film Festival in New York City, I'm sitting here with MJ Evans, or Margie Evans, and she's out of Colorado, and an author, another one of our participants in the author section. Now, I actually met MJ in Denver last year, but her book is Heart.
In the Heart.
In the Heart of a Mustang, right here, in the Heart of a Mustang. And this book we had with you in Denver last year, it's really, you know, I have not read all of this book, but it's the storyline and everything you described to me was really, really neat. So, since that time, you have also come out with two more books. The Stone of Courage, that's book two, right? Book one is the Stone of Mercy, book one, and the Stone of Courage, book two.
Right.
So tell us a little bit about these new books.
Okay, well, my real love with writing is anything horse-related, including horse fantasy characters. I have a series called the Mist Trilogy. It's about the noble and great horses who were chosen to become unicorns when they die. So a different twist on unicorns.
Okay.
When I teach my writing lessons to my students, I'm always telling them, be a centaur. Be one with your horse. And finally, I decided, I'm just going to write my next series on centaurs. So I started the Centaur Chronicles.
Okay.
And it's a fun fantasy about the land of Crestonia, the land of centaurs and ogres and cyclops.
Okay.
And a little race of half-human, half-fairy. We're called the Duende. I made them up. Of course, when you're an author, you can do that.
You can do that. Sure you can.
And so in this land, there has not been a righteous ruler for a century and a half. While the larger races have been battling for control of the throne, no one can hold her because the rightful heir to the throne is the one who wears the silver breastplate.
Okay.
But no one expected the silver breastplate to be given to a little Duende girl. She's only 3.5 feet tall. She's given the silver breastplate, but she must complete it by gathering the four stones of light. And the first stone is the Stone of Mercy. That's a green stone.
Okay.
The second stone is the Stone of Courage.
Okay.
The red stone. And the third one is the Stone of Integrity. It's purple and it comes out in January.
Okay.
And the fourth and final stone is the Stone of Wisdom. And when she has all four of those stones, she'll be worthy to be the queen.
Wow.
It's really fun.
It is fun. It sounds great.
I'm excited about it.
It sounds to me like Harry Potter has nothing on you.
Nothing on me.
Because here we've mixed, it's all around the horse.
Horse.
That is true.
I consider myself a Mozart writer as opposed to a Beethoven writer. If you've ever seen original manuscripts of Mozart.
I have not seen original manuscripts.
They're flawless.
Okay.
We went to Salzburg. They are flawless. There's not a scribble or...
And Beethoven's are all over the place.
Yes, Beethoven, scratch, scratch, rewrite, scratch, scratch, rewrite. Some authors write like Beethoven and come out with a beautiful product like Beethoven did. Other people write like I do. They have it all in their head and then they just have to get it down with it. I talk to people who are would-be writers all the time and they say, well, I got 3 chapters into it, but I keep revising and revising and revising. And I tell them, no, no, no. You write down that whole story. It won't be perfect, but get the story down.
Mm-hmm.
And then give it a rest. Then go back and start revising.
Very, very good.
But at
point.
Least you have your story down.
Right.
If otherwise, you never get it done.
Yeah. But the ending keeps moving.
I know.
It always gets away from
and the beginning moves, and the middle completely changes.
That's right.
So you have to get the story down, and then you can do your revisions and embellishments.
And writing is really fun.
And especially if you were saying your brain works a little differently than mine, it's probably not as crazy as mine. Which is is good.
Everybody's wired slightly
that's
different.
That's right. That's
okay.
Right. And I, you know, people say, how did you come up with these? And I just have these crazy ideas in my head.
Yeah.
But when in the Heart of a Mustang, this book is not a fantasy book. And it was based on my fascination with horses as healers. and working for PATH International and seeing how horses healed at-risk youth. And in that case, I combined that interest with my interest in wild Mustang herds in the West. So of course in this book I promote adoption and what a great. And this book focuses on at-risk youth.
Right.
And the healing power horses have for at-risk youth. And the confidence and self-esteem that they develop in being able to accomplish something.
Right.
And in the book, the old cowboy does start a drill team with the boys.
There you go.
Yeah.
I did drill team for years.
Yeah.
That's fun.
Anyway. I still do drill team every Monday.
Oh, wow.
We call ourselves the Senior Heirs.
Named after the Western Heirs.
Named after the Western Heirs, but we're the Senior Heirs.
This book is In the Heart of the Mustang, and this is the one that MJ wrote that is about the healing powers of the horse. Or you can go into this four-part series of fantasies. Book one.
The Stone of Mercy.
Yeah. Book two is The Stone of Courage, and the other two are yet to come. But just look it up. It's just Google MJ Evans, horse author, you'll get it. Thank you.
Thank you for inviting me to visit with you.
My pleasure. Thank you. We're here at the Equus Film Festival, and hey, we do books too.
And if it ain't the sweetest harmony you've ever heard, well, there's always sugar for the horses.